Okay, good morning, afternoon, evening, whenever you're watching this. I just thought I'd just put it together that it's swarming season's about to start, and this is basically what you need to do to get going before the bees. Yeah, they're going to be swarming in your area, and when they arrive en masse. The best thing is when you actually see the scout bees, they come along and their flight patterns are a bit jerky, but they're not direct into the hive like they would normally into a normal hive. They're actually jerky, and that's them checking out the dimensions, actually weighing, they're looking to see how big the void is in which they're going to be filling. So what I've got over here, I've got a fire frame, what the guys call a nuke or what you could call a capture box, and I've got a normal hive over here which takes 10 frames. You can use both of them to catch bees in. The bees aren't fussy, they just want to know that they've got ample enough space. Five is usually on the small side, but if you're just getting a smaller swarm that's kind of come off, they're not going to be too confident to go into a large hive. And vice versa. So if it's a large hive, they're not going to be too keen to go into a smaller box. What I like to do is, first thing is it's wax. It's like, it's if your neighbors are moving home, that you're not going to move in unless things are, when you're selling a house, basically, you've got to have cookies just on the day. So this is what I like to do. I've got a whole lot of leftover wax. I've got a ball here from my removal. And what I do is I just melt this down. I've got a, fortunately, this is the latest and greatest. You can get it from Checkers. 150 bucks, it's a blowtorch. I'm just going to melt a little bit of this wax. Basically, I'm just going to dribble that melted wax onto the top of those frames there. Basically, it's going to give them a smell, just to say, hey, this is home. This is where the home's at. And this is where we're going to be going in. You'll even find, I've got a couple of hives here. Within the next bit, the smell is going to get back to them. And actually, bees will start hovering around here and investigating. The other thing is nice to know is you can also get yourself some lemongrass oil. Dischem has it. And what you're going to do is you're just going to put a couple of drops, usually on a piece of cotton wool, and you can just pop it in at the bottom. What I like to do sometimes is just put it on a frame or two, just three or four drops. It's going to soak into the wood, and that's the pheromone. That bees operate on smell, and they just love it, and they're just going to come back and actually got to investigate this. I've got a dead out which passed away. I've frozen the sheet over here. There's a bit of manky bits, I just removed them. There's a bit of drone comb, I also removed that. I'm going to put that in there. That's like basically, that's just yum. So that's it. I'm going to put that. I'm going to put it up into a nice place in the shade generally, up on top of a roof or somewhere, out of the way, where no one's going to see it. Put the lid on, and that's it. And it's the waiting game. It can happen in 2 days, it can happen in 2 weeks. Maybe once every 2 weeks, you're going to just redo a little bit of lemongrass oil. And that's it. Cheers.